tell me about it. These toe stops suck. I tried all of them. They feel like plastic and they keep popping off the stems.
I cannot stop.
I wish somebody would help us. Help us.
Do you hear that? I think we're needed.
Captain Antic, can you help me?
Antic skate boots.
Reckless wheels.
I wish somebody would help us.
It's okay, guys. I've got this one.
Wow! It's the Gumballer!
Try these. Gumball toe stops. All natural rubber, no dyes, traction for any surface, and these will never pop off.
Jeez, thanks, mister!
This commercial is brought to you by Green Monster Roller Sports, Gumball Toe Stops, and Derby Skins.
Back. Hi, and we are back. I'm AK 40 Ounce here with Mike Checks, bringing you number 4 versus number 5 in this tournament, Division 1 from Salem, Oregon. We've got the Detroit Derby Girls ranked number 15th overall coming in against the number 20 Charm City All-Stars.
Indeed, and the Charm City Roller Girls ranked number 5 in this tournament. We're going to get right into the starting lineup for the Charm City All-Stars. We've got number 110, Yvetta Work, number 14, Feral Cat, number 16, one of the co-captains, I Am Pain, number 187, Nuckin Futz, number 2, Ochit, number 26, Just Carol, number 2AA, Battery Operated, number 34, Lady Kaboom, the second co-captain, number 415, Holly Go Hardly, number 6, Hitsburg, number 8, Free Radical, number 91, Loretta Scars. T2 is Ally B. Back. And top 5 is Susie Powell. The Charm City Roller Girls are coached by Blind Banshee and Mr. Pistol.
All right. One thing of note with that roster, I Am Pain is a healthy scratch. She will be on the bench, but she will likely not be skating as she is dealing with an injury. For the Detroit Derby Girl All-Stars, we've got Spanish Assassin, the captain, number 223, 247, Boo Delivers, 28, Racer McChaser, number 3, Roxanna Hardplace, 303, Bruzy Sue, 33, Cookie Rumble, number 40, Murder City Mistress, 45, Fetisleys, 46, Fatal Femme, number 6, L McPherson, 620, Laser Beam, 666, Ellison Chevrolet, 99, USS Denterprise, and MGS4 Meryl Slaughterberg on the bench wearing the A Coach Speedy Pants along with Blossom Bruzo.
Well, and AK, real quick before we get this bout underway, I do want to mention the fact that in the rivalry between these two teams, Charm City holds a 3-1 advantage. However, keep in mind, Detroit coming into this tournament, the higher ranked team.
That's right. This season, 4-5, the record for Detroit. Charm City with a little more vigorous schedule. 8-7 is their record. Starting things off on the jam line in the black for Detroit, Allison Shoverland up against number 26, Just Carol, in the athletic gold for Charm City. There we see Allison Shoverland jumping out to that front wall of Charm City defenders. Just Carol dealing with a wall of Detroit in the back. Allison Shoverland, a couple blockers go down for Charm City, and she is out. Lee Jammer, Detroit.
And it wasn't until that three wall fell apart in the front of the pack that she was able to get through and pick up Lee Jammer for her team.
Detroit bridging a little bit there at the end of the initial pass, pardon me, for Just Carol. She gets out, coming around. Allison Shoverland going to get in, bumped to the inside, but she does pick up 3 points, no points, going up for Charm. Detroit draws first blood.
Allison Shoverland doing a nice job making sure that she re-entered behind all of the blockers there. Did not want to draw an early track cut.
Next jam getting ready to start it out. Everybody on the Antic Boots jammer line. Back behind it, we have number 45, Feta Sleaze for Detroit. And that's Nuckin Futz, number 187 for Charm. Scrum start, a lot of bodies grinding it out right there. Feta Sleaze finding some room in the inside. It picks up Lead Jammer, busting right through. And we have our first penalty, Mike.
Indeed we do. She was able to get through her team set up in front of the jam line, allowing for that quick Lead Jammer status.
It's Lady Kaboom off to the box for Charm City, so it would be a 4-3 pack advantage. Quickly a 3-3 as Racer McChaser for Detroit now in the box. quickly in. That was an out of play for Racer, but right there, Feta Sleaze picking up 4 points for the Detroit Derby Girls.
Detroit extending their lead right now, 7-0, as we are just a minute and a half into play in this first half between these teams.
There you see Feta Sleaze calling it off just before Nuck and Futz can get back around and put up any points. So it'll be 0-0 on that pass and a 4-0 jam for Detroit.
Well, fans, Rydell is the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, Rydell Skates. Find out more at RydellSkates.com.
And we see on your screen two tough competitors right there, Just Carroll and Roxanna Hardplace, both veterans and have been strong blockers for their teams, taking jammer turns throughout their career, and they're matched up right now. Just Carroll looking for room up front, gets a hit from Spanish Assassin. That'll slow her down just enough for Elle McPherson to get out in front and then lead jammer to get picked up by Roxanna Hardplace.
Elle McPherson finding room to accelerate on the inside lane of the far straightaway. She is through lead jammer.
Booty Livers knocking Just Carroll into the infield. Came in legally, but right there picks up a track cut major, and it's going to be two off to the box. Oh, Chit going to sit along with Just Carroll, and we've got our first power jam of the game, Mike, and a grand slam for Roxanna Hardplace.
Well, Detroit was up 3-2 in the blocker department at one point. However, rejoining the action, number 34, Lady Kaboom, 3-on-3 in the pack right now.
Racer McChaser as well out of the box, going up looking to put an offensive block on, does not connect. Right there, Roxanna Hardplace trading the star to Racer McChaser. I think that's the quickest we've ever seen a star pass in a roller derby bout. And 5 more points going up. Jammer this time, though.
Not to mention that, Racer McChaser doing a nice job making sure that she received the star pass while she was still in play.
Oh, Racer McChaser forced to the infield right there and cut the track. So this power jam is going to be cut short. We're going to play a jammer switch right now. Just Carroll will be released when Racer sits, and Racer will serve the same amount of time that Carroll did in the box.
Still a 4-3 blocker advantage in favor of Detroit. Charm City not able to put points on the scoreboard yet, looking to see if they can crack that right now.
Still on her initial pass is Carroll. Only 18 seconds ticking off in this jam. Not sure if they'll be able to break through. Good bridge right here from Detroit. Elle McPherson out front trying to slow her down. Does a fine job of that. But Carroll, quick speed out of the pack, coming back around looking to put points up before those 4 seconds are off the clock. Big takedown right there from Booty Livers. And that's going to be a major forearm right at the end of the jam. 3 more points go up for Racer McChaser before she went to the box. And the first 2 points for Charm City makes it 20-2 here early in this competition.
Charm City had to work for both of those points, choosing to go with a stagnant offense on the first pass and letting Just Carroll battle the blockers in that pass. Played a little bit of offense in the second pass, though, AK.
So now we've got Susie Powell donning the star for Charm City. Power start for them. Racer McChaser standing in the box, and a quick lead jam here for Charm City, and a multiplayer block drawn on Laser Beam. So it's going to be a 4-2 pack advantage for Susie Powell, coming around on her scoring pass. Gets slowed up right there by Bruzy Sue. Goes back and forth with her. Quickly speeds out of that pack. Picks up a grand slam for Charm.
Charm City taking advantage of the 4-2 blocker advantage that they've got on the track right now. Their jammer is back in play, though.
Racer McChaser forced to the infield right there, comes back in, draws a penalty, and another grand slam. Good job by Charm City early in this jam, taking advantage of their power start and their blocker advantage.
Active offense in the backfield by Detroit springs their jammer on her initial pass.
On 1 foot, staying inbounds long enough to call it off, and putting 4 points up is Susie Powell. And Charm City storming back now, 20 points on the board for Detroit. Charm City with 16. We've played 550 in this 4-5 matchup here on day one of Salem Division I playoffs.
On fans, we would like to thank PrintCo Graphics for all your printing needs. Hit up PrintCoGraphics.com.
Allison Shoverland, the jammer for Detroit, and she is up against number 187, Nuckin' Futz. Good movement by Futz. Gets to the inside, found her open lane, and picked up lead jammer just ahead of Allison Shoverland.
Allison Shoverland less than 2 strides behind right now.
Quick strike right here for Nuck and Futz. Pack getting spread out, no pack called. They have to disengage, and Nuck and Futz puts four up for Charm City. Nice offensive block right there from Booty Livers. Opens up some room, and Ellison Shoverland picks up three before the whistles blow.
Our scoreboard right now reads Detroit 23, Charm City 20, as we have just over 23 minutes left to play in this first half of action. Just Carroll on the Antic Boot jam line.
And she is opposed by Feta Sleaze. Right there you see Detroit taking the back wall. They have all four blockers out there to start. Three blockers for Charm City. Razor McChaser in there pushing bodies around, trying to open up a hole for Feta Sleaze. She's got one on the outside, cuts to the inside and picks up lead jammer for Detroit. So far so good in the LJ category. For Detroit.
Feta Sleaze muscling her way through that pack. Just Carroll now fighting with two blockers at the front of the pack. She's still working on her initial pass.
Feta Sleaze back around right on the tail of Just Carroll. Ooh, beautiful. Just a light Johnny Crash right there to hold up Carroll and free some room up for Feta Sleaze to put 5 points up.
Feta Sleaze twice going to the inside rail, twice finding success with it so far this jam for Detroit. Just Carroll has cleared the pack on her initial pass for Charm City.
Feta Sleaze comes into the pack, finds a lot of yellow in front of her, gets taken down to the infield, puts up 1 point before that one's all over. So that little plus one will take Detroit to 29-20 for Charm. And we're closing in on 8 minutes and 5-6 seconds gone in this first half.
Well, as you can see, Detroit blockers a little spread out off the jam line. That's because Charm City blockers are sitting on the pivot line for the second time so far this game, AK.
And not something you see a lot, but we've seen it a little bit here this weekend early. Right now, we've got Roxanna Hardplace wearing the three and the star for Detroit in the black. And she's up against Susie Powell. Working on her toe stops back and forth, trying to get around those Detroit defenders. Gets bumped to the outside right there. Still looking for him, taken down right there by Booty Livers. Meanwhile, up front, Roxanna Hardplace grinds through on the inside, rolls around number six, hits Berg and picks up lead jammer for the D.
Great defense in the backfield for Detroit by USS Denterprise, doing a great job holding back Powell, who has now just cleared the pack on her initial pass.
Long bridge for Detroit, last line of defense, head to ease off. That was Fatal Femme and let her through. Roxanna Hardplace back around. Another 3 points for Detroit, and they continue to add the pennies and the nickels and the dimes.
That pushes our score to Detroit 32, Charm City 20. We are under 21 minutes left in this first half.
Full contingent of blockers for both teams. Detroit takes the back line in front of the Antic Boot jammer line. Racer McChaser getting low right next to Nuck and Futz. Ooh, Nuck and Futz gets tripped up right there over Murder City Mistress. No penalty, she fell small. Futz looking for him on the outside, gets ground out right there by the Detroit pivot. Gets some speed up, races past Bruzy Suba, picked up a major forearm, and it's another power jam now for Detroit. Racer McChaser is your lead jammer.
Nuck and Futz saw the light of day there, using her small frame to weasel her way through that pack, saw daylight, and then was sent to the notorious RED penalty box.
Racer McChaser getting low, coming in right there, gets hit. Defender goes down, and she takes that last two wall, finds room on the outside, picks up a grand slam.
Detroit blockers set up just in front of the jam line. Charm City blockers, all three of them, right in front of them. Detroit looking for a little bit of active offense there.
Tiptoeing on that inside line. Racer McChaser found her way through. 10 points on this power jam so far for the one they call the Phenom. Oh, right there. Loose wall for Charm City. Gets a little distracted on the outside by Feta Sleaze. That opens up a hole. Racer McChaser now at 15 on this power jam.
Sort of a passive-aggressive offense there. Detroit faking like they were going to be aggressive on the offense. Instead, danced backwards. That caused enough confusion with Charm City.
Oh, what a great move right there by Free Radical, the former DC skater. On the inside, she was ahead of Racer when she got knocked out. Came all the way back, drew that cut. That was a heads-up play right there for Charm.
So Racer McChaser going to take a seat in the notorious RED penalty box for 1 minute.
Nuck and Futz now done with her initial pass. Over onto turn two, we see the team setting up for Futz. Here she comes in. Black wall right there. Cookie Rumble looking for room, went directional, and we'll go to the box for that direction of gameplay penalty. No pack called, and Nuck and Futz is through. That's a grand slam answering back on her power jam.
Charm City doing a great job waiting for that no pack to be called, allowing Futz to get through.
Pack springs into action just before Futz can get back in there, and no points will go on the board. No, scratch that. 2 points. That was 2 points for Detroit before Racer went into the box. So that will push their total up to 49. 25 points for Charm. We have 18:07 remaining in this first half.
And fans, we'd like to thank Fast Girl Skates. Our mission is educating skaters. Get schooled at fastgirlskates.com.
4-3 power start right here for Charm City. They use it to their advantage and a quick lead jammer before she hits the pivot line right there for Susie Powell.
Susie Powell trying to look for some offense. Got some in the form of number 2, Ochit, trying to go up and play offense for her. Not able to take advantage of that, though. Finally cleared the pack on that scoring pass. 5 points on Charm City's side of the scoreboard.
Yeah, nice attempt on the lateral hitting from Booty Livers, but Susie Powell had enough room to get around right there. Taken down hard. Booty Livers delivering that big hit. She's already been a force in the pack for Detroit. Racer McChaser out now, fighting with that back wall of Charm City. Another big takedown up front. Huge hit.
That was
Roxanna Hardplace.
Exactly. I was going to say that was Roxanna Hardplace delivering that blow. However, Susie Powell quick to recover. 5 more points, Charm City.
Spanish Assassin with an offensive block. Springs Racer McChaser. Detroit now down to 2 defenders. Back to 3 as Cookie Rumble is out of the box. It'll be a 3-on-3 right now. Susie Powell knocked down right there, and she will call it off as she gets back up. No points on that pass for her, though.
Ochit on her own trying to stop Racer McChaser one-on-one, and Ochit giving up a little bit in the size department there. Racer McChaser able to barrel her way through the pack on that scoring pass for Detroit.
Is the pack. Detroit again taking the back line in front of the jammers. Allison Shoverland with the star for Detroit, and she is opposed by Just Carroll, number 26 for Charm City. But Allison Shoverland right there, quick lead jammer for Detroit.
Allison Shoverland has had a lot of success when she's been jamming against Just Carroll so far this bout. Just Carroll having a hard time with that Detroit defense.
A lot of blockers out there going multi-direction. Keeping it forward, thankfully, nobody getting direction of gameplay penalties. Quick 3 points right there for Allison Shoverland, and a call-off just before Carroll gets back into the pack, Mike.
Detroit extending their lead to 17 points at 52-35 as we are closing in on the 15-minute mark in this first half of play.
Allie B back, her first turn on the Antic Boot jammer line up against Roxanna Hardplace. Again, we see some pivot action. Both packs up near the pivot line, 3-on-3.
Well, and it seems like when both teams are down blockers is where we see them start to move up to the pivot line, AK.
That's right. They're going to bleed a blocker right there, and that leaves a 1-on-1 for Roxanna Hardplace, just quickly taken care of. She is your lead jammer for Detroit right there. Gets back to the pack, knocked into the infield. Nice defense by Battery operated.
Allie B back clears the pack on her initial pass.
But Roxanna Hardplace sneaks out just past that, picks up 4 points, hands to the hips, calls it quits. We'll do it again in 30 ticks.
Well, fans, we'd like to thank Anthem Cider by Wandering Agnes Cider Works. They are proud to be the cider partner of this WFTDA playoff tournament. Get you some. That's Anthem Cider.
Tis the season, Mike.
Indeed it is, sir.
And here we go again. Nuck and Futz jumping back and forth. So good on her toes is the diminutive jammer from Charm City, but Racer McChaser plows through, picks up lead jammer for Detroit.
Well, two definitely different styles of jamming there. one who is just powering her way through, the other one with great lateral movement back and forth.
Right there, you see Racer McChaser gets in, pushes those hips forward, picks up all 4 points. Now, Futz was in there, but it was that extra little effort from Racer McChaser that made it a 4-1 jam.
Well, Racer McChaser has been around the track a couple of times and very successful in putting points on the board so far this bout. We've got a score of 60-36 as we are under 14 minutes left to play in the first half.
5 seconds to call from the jam timer. You see the team's a little mixed up there. Detroit, again, opting to go for that back wall and a sneaky star pass. And a quick lead jammer for Detroit, Allison Chuverland. Charm tried to pass the star over the blockers. And Booty Livers picked up a penalty in that.
Well, Detroit doing a great job with their offense for their jammer right off the jam line there. She's able to traverse the pack quickly on her scoring pass, and that's 4 more points for Detroit.
Yeah, Holly Go Hardley was the recipient of that star pass right there. Did not get back around when the jam was called off. So with just under 13 minutes remaining in the first half of gameplay here in the 4-5 matchup, Detroit leads 64-36. Thank you for joining us on WFTDA.TV. Again, I'm AK40Ounce here with Mike Checks, bringing you all the action from lovely Salem, Oregon. Jam starts. We've got Nuck and Futz up against that's Feta Sleaze for Detroit. Nuck and Futz, again, so good back and forth. Her lateral movement is incredible to watch. But Feta Sleaze right now up in front, one to beat. Some very, very good defense right there from Charm City's Just Carroll. And Feta Sleaze sneaks past the last line of defense that was Free Radical and picks up lead jammer for Detroit.
Just Carroll did a great job of defense out front. So well, in fact, that allowed Free Radical to come up and try and truck and trailer off of that. Detroit still able to get their jammer through, though, on her initial pass.
Unable to get their jammer through yet is Charm City. Nuck and Futz still dealing with a back two wall right there. Gets broken up by the blocker out of the box, but great job by that's Racer McChaser to jump back in front. She is dealing with Nuck and Futz, holds her back a little bit. 5-point grand slam for Feta Sleaze on that last one. Coming back around, looking to strike, put more up for Detroit. Jumps to the outside, hit right there by Hitzberg. Spun around on Free Radical and calls it off. Picks up 2 points before that one's all over, Mike.
I don't know how Feta Sleaze was able to keep both of her skates in bounds there in turn four. Excellent display of athleticism by her, picking up the points, calling off the jam. Well, fans, real quick, we would like to thank Adam Wheels. Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. Check them out at adamwheels.com.
Here we go. Again, Roxanna Hardplace up against Susie Powell. Susie Powell, mixed results as a jammer right here. Looking pretty good. She does have one defender to beat. Fatal Femme keeping the booty on her, but it gets spread out, and lead jammer goes to Charm City.
Susie Powell choosing not to go lateral there, deciding just to push and push and push, and finally got clear for lead jammer.
That was a good move. They only had one blocker that could bridge, Janelle McPherson, and it was getting spread out. So instead of going lateral and burning some of that energy and time and space on the track, she just pushed it up. That's a great move right there. She gets in again, slowed up by Fatal Femme one more time, but she picks up 3 and calls it off. No points for Detroit.
Our score right now, Detroit 71, Charm 39, as we have just slightly more than 10 minutes left to play in this opening half.
That's right, Mike. Before we get going, I'd like to mention real quick that the winner of this game is going to play the winner of Bad and Victorian, who will play tonight at 6. So I'm sure whoever wins this one will be watching that one, eagerly anticipating the victor. Right now, Racer McChaser is the jammer of note for Detroit, and Oh Chit is jamming for Charm City. Oh Chit, a lot of blocking so far in this game. Racer McChaser now picking up a major track cut back to the box for her, and it's a power jam now for Oh Chit and Charm City.
Oh Chit able to barrel her way through, lead jammer going to Charm City there.
Yeah, Detroit had that two wall. Feta Sleaze came over, hit her, and that opened up some room in the wall. Sometimes it's better to just maintain that wall than go for the big hits. Oh Chit is the call from the fans of Charm City. Major track cut forced right there. by the Detroit Defenders. So we're going to have another jammer switch, Mike.
Well, and that is one of the negative effects of passive offense, is that in making your jammer push against those walls, she is opening herself up much more to a penalty.
Well done right there by Charm City, bridging back, but all those defenders spread out, makes an easy pass for Racer McChaser, finishing her initial pass because she was sent to the box on her lead pass. Now eligible to score for Detroit. Jammer in the box for Charm City.
Detroit going with passive offense there, but it doesn't seem to matter. Racer McChaser through for another 5 points.
Yeah, so good at just pushing those walls is Racer. We'll see what she does this time, how Detroit responds. Right there, big hit from Racer McChaser into the shoulder of one of those Charm City girls. They say it's a back block, and she's going to the box, so it's going to be another power jam. 5 more points right there for Ochit and Charm City.
Well, and again, we talk about the contrasting styles of these jammers. Detroit with the bigger, more powerful jammers. Charm City with the more wiry, lateral-moving jammers, as displayed right there by Ochita. She clears the pack for 5 points.
Passive offense right there for Charm City, letting Detroit bridge out. They're going to do slacker with an overachiever, but before Ochit can get back around, the jam is called off, and we've got a timeout now called by Detroit. Time on the clock reads 7:47. Score reads 76, Detroit 49, Charm City.
On fans, we've got some love for Knuck and Futt. CeCe Bang Bang, her sister, sending a shout out via Twitter. Remember the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. You can use that and harass myself an AK-40 ounce if you wish. We're fine with that.
Indeed. See the discussion right there from Detroit. Now, a quick replay. Racer McChaser came in too hot right there, picked up the back block, and that's what sent her to the box. So it'll be a power start for Charm City coming out of this Detroit timeout. First of three. Of course, both teams do get 3 timeouts per game and 1 official review per half if they choose to use it.
Well, now, AK, I mentioned this earlier, and you and I have talked about this before, the stagnant or passive offense, whichever you would prefer. Again, on that replay there, we saw Racer McChaser forced to go up against that wall on her own. Did come in a little bit hot, did draw the back block penalty. Again, I sometimes wonder, had there been a more active offense, would that have happened?
That's right, and that's something teams have to look at as they're going through about, is the passive offense working, or do they have to go up and you know, throw somebody at that wall? Right now, Susie Pau, the jammer for Charm City, getting forced to the infield by Spanish Assassin. Offensive block, nice pick set right there by one of her, that was the pivot for Charm City, and that springs Susie Pau, lead jammer right now for Charm.
Well, and Detroit's captain, Spanish Assassin, almost drawing that track cut penalty. Very great awareness, and we see her doing it again right there in turn one.
Susie Pau coming in just ahead of Roxanne Hardplace and Spanish Assassin, who were speeding back. And that paid off for her because they were still moving backwards when she came in. It was only one defender to beat. Comes up again. Susie Pau slows up, looking at what she's going to do to get through this. No pack called. They got to let her go. Roxanne Hardplace off to the box. And here comes Racer McChaser out of the notorious RED penalty box.
And we've got Roxanne Hardplace on an out-of-play penalty, and also Spanish Assassin heading to the notorious RED penalty box.
Susie Pau just sped into the pack right there. Hit a Detroit defender, got knocked down again. Runs into Fatal Femme and goes down.
On Susie Pau returning to the bench area, very upset, motioning to her jaw as though she had been hit once or twice in the face there. And we now get a chance to look at this replay.
Susie Pau right there coming up on the pack. Big hit right there. That one was clean from Fatal Femme. And it looked like, just from what I saw, when she came back around, she initiated on Fatal Femme and might have led with her chin. So that's where that contact could have happened. No call from the refs. And we start now with Allison Shoverland jamming up against number 2, Ochit.
Ochit finds herself at the front of the pack, but dropped in turn 3.
Ooh, 2 knockdowns right there from Racer McChaser. Ochit still on the ground. Allison Shoverland gets tangled up on her. 3-2 pack advantage. Detroit out in front, gets spread apart, and lead jammer goes to Charm City.
Charm City, great job of containment in the backfield, able to contain Allison Shoverland. Ochit pushing the opposing blockers forward, gets out for lead jammer.
Ooh, Ochit comes in fast, gets taken down right there, springs back up and calls it off. We'll see if there were any points. Major forearm being called right there at the end of the jam. 3 points do go up for Charm City. And Racer McChaser will sit for the major forearm right at the whistles.
76-66, Charm back within 10 points now as we near the 5-minute mark left in this first half of play.
Detroit penalty trouble really stacking up right here near the end of the first half. Booty Livers, the solo defender. Cookie Rumble going to wear the star, one of the longtime defensive leaders for Detroit. And Nuck and Futz out. Great movement again. It's so good back and forth. Gets past Booty Livers, picks up lead jammer for Charm.
Cookie Rumble very careful when she re-entered the track. Almost cut it. Took one more step back and came in legally. That's why she's still in play.
Futz as well took a kind of a crazy hit, spun her around. She just hopped up on those toe stops and kept on rolling. Grand slam right there for Charm City. They draw within five right now, 76-71. Here come the jammers again. Futz gonna call it off real quick. Cookie breathing down her neck. It'll be 0-0 on that pass.
Well, it was great play by Spanish Assassin, a great piece of offense on the far straightaway that sprung Detroit's jammer and caused that jam to be called quicker than Charm City would have liked.
And Spanish Assassin, she is the offensive leader in the home season for Detroit. Last couple seasons has put up great numbers, and as well here with the All-Stars, just has a knack for opening those holes for her jammer. All right, here we go. Quick inside, oh, Chit. Lead jammer, but a major track cut right there just as she was clearing the pack. So it's going to be a power jam now for the Detroit Derby girls.
From my vantage point, I thought that was deft footwork that got her through the pack. Unfortunately, it looks like it was coupled with a track cut. And
Feta Sleaze right there getting lead jammer, and then the ref waving it off because Ochit did have lead before she cut the track. So it'll be a 2-minute jam right now and a power jam for the first minute of it. 5 points going up right there for Feta Sleaze, and a big opportunity for Detroit to pull away a little bit before we go into halftime.
Feta Sleaze was being pushed to the outside of turn four, did a great job maintaining her balance and staying in bounds, traversed the pack and through now once again for yet another 5 points for Detroit.
Allie B back, coming back to the track for Charm City. Bring their defense back up to three blockers. Tough two wall up front for Charm. Grinds Feta to the inside. Wow, tenacious defense right there from the Charm City defenders. But, wow, she just kept on pushing, hopped on through, and another 5 points goes up for Feta Sleaze.
Tenacious D, but some active offense by Detroit helping her get through on that scoring pass.
See Detroit with the front wall right now, looking to play some backwards offense. They do open up some room. Free Radical slowly kind of chasing Feta Sleaze. She gets locked up, and that's another grand slam for Detroit.
Huge pileup in turn two. Ochit, quick recovery time, back up on her skates and through the pack on her initial pass.
And that's the thing, these Charm City jammers, they're all very spry, they're all springy, and they're all super quick. You get knocked down, but they spring right back up. Feta Sleaze with another 4-point scoring pass. Power jam is over, but there is no lead jammer. Just Carol, or I'm sorry, Ochit had it, but went to the box, so that was lost. Does run its full course with 3 more points going up for Charm City, and Ochit just, oh, fourth whistle went off just before Feta picked any up. That's going to make it 100-74 in favor of Detroit.
Detroit able to push their lead in that jam on the strength of that truncated power jam. 26 points separating these teams. Period clock reads 1 minute 30 seconds left to play.
Interesting start right here. Allison Shoverland lining up behind Susie Powell. Springs out in front of her, but made some strong resistance on the outside line from a four wall, a dynamic wall right there of Charm City. Works her way to the infield and picks up lead jammer for Detroit.
Charm going from a solid wall defense to a swarming defense there. Worked for them for a couple of seconds, but ultimately gave up lead jammer to Detroit.
Wow, soul-sucking hit coming across the side. It was Meryl Slaughterberg. She's going to pick up a penalty for that one. but that does open up room for her jammer and keeps the Charm City jammer locked up on her first pass. 5-point grand slam for Allison Trevorland.
Susie Powell getting assessed with a forearm penalty, going to send her to the notorious RED penalty box where she will sit for a minute. Detroit going to try and capitalize as much as they can with these waning few seconds of the first half.
Good bridge right there. Just Carroll forcing Allie to the outside, but she has to disengage. 5 points go up for Detroit on this power jam. 20 seconds and make that 17, 16, 15 left in this first half.
Interesting choice by Detroit. Charm City with a 4-3 blocker advantage.
Oh, it's going to pay off right here because it drew the direction of gameplay penalty on Holly Gohartley and Jess Carroll. So now it's a 3-on-2 in favor of Detroit as this power jam continues. 5 more points will be added to Detroit's score, pushing them up to 115.
Well, how about that? Detroit knew exactly what they were doing in that situation. Congratulations to them. Nice job so far. They set up again, 3 blockers in back. Now only 2 up front for Charm City.
Look at Allison Shoverland right there. She's got that, she's got height and just the physicality. Comes in, blasts her way through, picks up another scoring pass, and that will take us into halftime. The score on the board reads 120, Detroit 74, Charm City. And Mike, what a little bit of back and forth. Detroit has maintained the lead, but it's been a scrappy game, and Charm City is really keeping them on their toes.
Well, it was very much so up until the last 2 or 3 jams there, where Detroit was able to capitalize on some Charm City errors and jammer penalties. They went on a 44-3 run over the course of those few jams. You'll remember there was time about 7 or 8 minutes left to play in the first half where it was a 10-point bout, but Detroit really opened it up in that last couple minutes.
Yeah, and that's what they've got to do. You know, coming in to the second half, Detroit's got to keep it clean. They've gotten lucky, and they've also done a good job. You know, they're pairing up the luck and doing a good job of making their own luck on drawing those penalties on the Charm City Jammers. If they can continue to do that and stay out of the box, I know Racer McChaser is getting in, you know, she had some serious penalty trouble in the first half. Looked like they dialed back her playing time there. Maybe she just needs a minute to adjust or whatever the case may be, but she was playing pretty hot there. You know, she had some fury in her, and you could tell because she was picking up those aggressive penalties.
Indeed. Well, fans, we are going to send it to halftime here. I would like to thank the Cruise Skate Shop, offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007. You can check them out at cruiseskateshop.com. And remember, if you'd like to trash talk us, the announcers, use the Twitter and the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. AK, we'll bring it back after halftime.
That's right. So in about 13 minutes, we'll be back with the second half of Detroit Charm City right here on WFTDA.TV.
We're here in the helmet laboratories today testing some helmets. We are testing soft foam helmets versus hard foam helmets. We have the Lifer hard foam CPSC certified on the head form now. We're going to drop it from the drop tower and we're going to measure the G-force of the impact.
We're going to take this helmet up 2 meters for its drop.
In order to pass this test, this helmet must reduce the energy pulse to under 300 Gs. We hit 186.75 Gs. That's a pass. We've got a soft foam helmet on the head foam now. We're going to bring it up to the same distance we did the hard foam helmet and see what happens. As you can see, the soft foam helmet that was dropped from the same distance as the hard foam helmet registered an 827 peak G. The hard foam helmet registered a 186. 300 Gs passes the CPSC certified test. This helmet fails.
Welcome back. I'm AK40 Ounce here with Mike Checks, getting ready to bring you the second half of number 4 Detroit versus number 5 Charm City here from the Salem Division 1 playoffs, the last Division 1 playoffs. See which three teams will be joining the rest of them in Milwaukee. Mike, why don't you take us through scoring in the first half for Charm?
Well, for Charm City, the leading scorer, Susie Powell, with 41 points in 8 jams. That's an average of slightly greater than 5 points per jam. She has a total plus minus of positive 14, the only jammer for Charm City who has a positive plus minus. And she had a lead jammer percentage of 50%. She was lead jammer in 4 of the 8 jams she skated in. Rounding out the leading scorers for Charm City, we have Ochit with 16 points in 9 jams. Lead jammer 2/3 of the time, so 6 out of those 9 jams for her. Nuckin Futz picked up 15 points in 6 jams for 2.5 points per jam, a 33% lead jammer percentage, 2 for 6. And Just Carol, 9 jams, 2 points, did not pick up lead.
All right, for Detroit, leading scorer, leading all scorers in this game, Fetis Lees with 41 points. She's a plus 38 with a 75% lead percentage. We also got Allison Shoverland with 33 points in 6 jams, plus 26 with 67%. And Roxanna Hardplace with 20 points in her 9 jams and 75%. Racer McChaser, though, 26 points in 13 jams, just about 2 points per jam, 17% lead. And a big part of that is the time she spent in the box, Mike.
You are absolutely right. Racer McChaser in that first half, 6 penalties to her credit. For Detroit, Boo delivers with 4 penalties and Laser Beam with 3. Overall, Detroit with 17 penalties in the first half.
Charm City, on the other hand, 19 penalties, but a little bit more spread out. In a handful of skaters with 3 minutes in the box, Ochit, Just Carol, and Loretta Scars all sitting 3 minutes each, and the rest of those spread out. The difference is it's been power jams that Detroit has been able to capitalize on. Charms had them as well, and that's kept them closer. But Detroit, at the end, getting some big power jams. It takes us to 120-74 with 30 minutes left to play. Thank you for joining us here on WFTDA.tv.
Well, AK, it'll be interesting to see here in the second half of play. Charm City now has the bench at the Antic Skate Boot jam line. So, down 46 points. It's going to be interesting to see if the pendulum of momentum switches and how far.
Okay, Roxanna Hardplace, the jammer for Detroit, only jammer out there, 4-on-2, and she plows through, just pushes that 2-wall of Charm, splits them apart, and picks up lead jammer. Watch out, Susie Powell jumps right back in from the penalty box.
Susie Powell trying to barrel her way through the front of the pack.
but coming back around on her scoring passes, Roxanna Hardplace. That's going to be a grand slam for Detroit to open up the second half. Susie Powell being forced out right there. Booty Livers has been all over the Charm City Jammers right there. Great position. Jumps back in, and Boo stays on top of her.
Susie Powell, nice footwork there as she clears the pack on her initial pass.
And Roxanna Hardplace with four more points and a call-off makes it a 9-0 jam in favor of Detroit. Going to make it 129-74 here after one jam in the second.
Well, fans, I'd like to thank Derbalife.com. Liftoff provided by Derbalife, the official beverage of the WFTDA announcers, an all-natural energy drink for skaters and announcers alike. Visit Derbalife.com.
So we have the wide angle on the TV screen there, or your computer screen, however you have it set up at home. We have Charm City with their four blockers up on the pivot line. Detroit spread out. Nuck and Futz, the jammer for Charm. A little bit of room on the inside, and she makes it work. Lead jammer, Charm City. Fantastic job by Charm right there. They've got Fetis Lee still locked up, but here she comes finishing her initial pass.
Nuck and Futz did a good job of skating on the inside through turn three to pick up that lead jammer.
Back around looking for points. She's got Cookie Rumble out there with Laser Beam holding her back. Got past one defender, picked up 2 points for the blocker in the box as well. Be no points for Detroit, so 9-0 Detroit, and then 2-0 Charm City answering back. Three, the correction from the officials. So 129-77, 27:55 remaining in this bout. Mike, who do we have on the jammer line?
On the jammer line, we've got Susie Powell jamming once again for Charm City, and that's Allison Shoverland for Detroit.
Allison Shoverland, a lot of success in the first half. Again, right there, picking up a lead. Jammer fights through on the inside. Meanwhile, speeding through a wide open pack and finishing her initial pass is Susie Powell.
Charm City blockers did a nice job opening that hole in turn two for Susie Powell to roll through.
Allison Shoverland locked up in the pack, gets forced to the outfield and calls it off, but past one of the defenders, picked up 3 points as there are two Charm City skaters in the notorious RED penalty box. That's going to be a 3-0 jam in favor of Detroit.
Well, fans, you can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.TV. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more.
Here we go. Ochit jamming for Charm City. Ground to the outside right there by Cookie Rumble, who tiptoes backward, force her to come back. And lead jammer on the other side of the track is Roxanna Hardplace for the Detroit Derby Girls.
Detroit blockers getting hung up in the back of the pack right there. That allows Ochit to get through on her initial pass.
Roxanna Hardplace, two defenders, great juke move right there around the Charm City pivot, picks up 4 points and calls it off. So a 4-0 jam for Detroit.
Detroit moving the scoreboard to 136-77 as we have worked almost 4 minutes off the clock in the second half. Susie Powell again returning to the jam line for Charm City, and that's number 45, Feta Sleaze for Detroit.
Back wall for Detroit. Again, they have really favored getting their skates just in front of the Antic Boot jammer line. And it's paying off right there. Locked up in the back is Susie Powell, looking for room, not finding much. Little offensive block, springs her to the outside, runs into the Detroit jammer. Detroit defense gets back in front. One to beat. Al McPherson loses her skates right there, and lead jammer goes to Susie Powell.
Nice consistent wall defense on display by Charm City right there. However, Feta Sleaze gets through on her initial.
Susie Powell speeding back around. Detroit defenders trying to keep in front of her, but some great, great speed on her wheels for Susie Powell. It's forced out, taken down right there by Elle McPherson, but she does pick up 3 points, and calls it off before Detroit can get on the board.
Physical play. Both these teams coming out from a halftime, not afraid to mix it up with one another. Ochit taking the star once again for Charm City, and that is Allison Shoverland for Detroit. We have 4-on-4 in the pack to start, AK.
Yeah, Charm City again favoring the pivot line. giving that Detroit jammer some room. I wonder if they're hoping to get her to draw a back block, but so nimble is Allison Cheverland. Picks up lead jammer right there for Detroit. Some stalwart defense from Charm City, but just great movement from Allie. One to beat right now for Ochit, and she is free on her initial pass.
Ochit tried to go low into the outside, but amazing defense by Detroit kept her contained almost the full length of the track there.
Offensive knockdown clears some room for Allison Cheverland. Pushes just past Just Carroll, picks up 4 points, hands to the hips, and no points for Charm. So low scoring back and forth here in the second half, Mike.
Big credit to Just Carroll. Did not have the her best night as a jammer to start this bout. Moved into the pivot position and really has been flourishing as a blocker for Charm City. On the jam line, Susie Powell for Charm City and Roxanne Hardplace for Detroit. And again, two in a row. That's 4-on-4 in the pack to start, AK.
That's right. This time, though, Charm City taking the back wall. Oh, great speed right there from Susie. Powell picks up lead jammer. Roxanne Hardplace now finishing her initial pass. Susie Powell loses her skates, though, on the turn.
Well, earlier in the VRDL bout, we saw some of the jammers checking the corners on those tracks like they were having a little bit of traction problem. We had not seen that so far this bout until right then.
2 points go up for Charm. It was an interesting approach from Susie Powell. Came in really fast, but just spun around it and used her momentum to get around that one Detroit blocker and call it off.
Detroit 140, Charm 82, 7 minutes gone here in the second half of play. Number 45, Fettis Lees on the jam line. Opposite 187, Nuckin Futz for Charm City.
4-4 again, Detroit out in front this time. Charm City was not having much success taking that front wall. They're trying to change it up. We'll see if it pays off. Ooh, getting tripped up right there as Fettis Lee is going to draw the low block on Holly Go Hardly. Lead jammer goes to Nuckin Futz in Charm City. Fettis Lee's out and just chewing up the real estate behind Nuckin Futz.
Charm City having some more success now that they're the ones trying to line up right in front of the jam line.
Great lateral defense right there. Laser beam got bumped to the inside right before Futz got up, sped back in and stayed in front of her. 0-0 at the end of that one. And that is some impressive defense from the diminutive blocker from the D.
Well, fans, Bruised Skate Noose is the original over-the-shoulder roller skate holder. Find out more about them at facebook.com/bruisedskatenoose.
Here we go, Ochit with a low down. Jammerstar gets stood up right away by Spanish Assassin. Meanwhile, Allison Cheverland forced to the infield, forced to come back, and has to reset. Tough defense from both these teams, but Allison Cheverland finds a lot of room between some of her pals from the D and picks up lead jammer. Meanwhile, Ochit gets past El McPherson. There you go. And finishes her initial pass.
Well, Detroit right up in front of the jam line. Detroit, lead jammer. Coincidence? Maybe.
The world may never know. Allison Cheverland hits the back right there, gets slowed up, and another 0-0 jam. .140-82 is our score with 21 minutes on the dot remaining in this bout. Again, this is 4 versus 5. Winner plays winner of Bad versus Victorian. Matchup I'm sure everybody is looking forward to, Mike.
Roxanna Hard plays on the jam line for Detroit. Opposite Susie Powell once again for Charm City. Charm City this time lining up on the jam line and
into the scrum and out of the massive bodies. First comes Roxanna Hardplace, lead jammer.
Now you might have seen battery operated skating opposite the direction of play all the way back around to the pack. She was called for an illegal procedure starting out of play, had to rejoin the pack from the front.
Quick scoring pass right there for Roxanna Hardplace. 4-0 jam, speeds just past Just Carroll and calls it off.
Well, and Susie Powell getting Aussie love from Colonel Panic in Sydney. Susie Powell got quite a fan club out there in internet land. On the jam line, Fettis Slees representing Detroit.
And Nuckin Futz will oppose her in the athletic gold for Charm City out of Baltimore, Maryland.
Charm City this time right on the Antic Skate Boot jam line.
You mentioned it coming in that they are on the jam line, their benches, and it's made a difference here. Fettesley's forced to the outside, comes back in, but out in front, Nuck and Futz pass the spread pack, picks up lead jammer for Charm City. Al McPherson off to the box for Detroit along with Fatal Femme, so it's going to be a 4-2 pack advantage. Here comes Nuck and Futz. Gets slowed up a little bit by a hit right there from Booty Liver, shakes it off, picks up four, and burns around the track.
Well, Feral Cat had done a nice job trying to hold back Fettesley's on her initial pass, and that was just long enough for Nuck and Futz to pick up those points.
Yeah, another strong defensive stand right there for Charm City, holding back Fettesley's on her scoring pass. Our score, 144-86 in favor of Detroit, just under 19 minutes remaining.
Well, fans, if you aren't able to be here, I'm sorry that you're not, but you can check out photos from the WFTDA photo booth sponsored by Viva Las Vegas Skates at facebook.com/WFTDA.
Here we go with Allison Shoverland donning the red and black star for Detroit. Just Carroll moving all the way around to the outside, got caught up on the inside, sped past the last Detroit defender, lead jammer Charm City, but Allison Shoverland is just a stride or two behind her. Ooh, Carroll picking up some speed right now, lengthening that distance, but Allison Shoverland closing it again.
Well, if I'm not, I'm sorry to interrupt you there.
Oh, that's fine.
I was going to say, if I'm not mistaken, that was just Carroll's first lead jammer status of this bout.
Ooh, a major illegal procedure for contact after the whistle puts Allison Shoverland in the box. And we have a full notorious RED penalty box of Detroit skaters. It's going to be a power start here for Charm City.
Well, and Susie Powell, the jammer to take advantage of that for Charm City.
55 points the difference right now. Susie Powell looking to chew up some of that lead right there. Quick lead jammer pass those two Detroit defenders.
And even though it was a stagnant offense, it only took her 4 seconds to get through that pack. Now we have some active offense.
A little bit of active defense as well, but an active jammer, a little overactive, loses her wheels coming out of turn one, but does pick up 5 points for Charm City.
Well, that active offense meant that Susie Powell only took 2 seconds to get through the pack that time once she hit that wall.
Ooh, speaking of hit, big takedown right there. Booty Livers with another cold shoulder in two. Susie Powell springs back up, though, now trying to grind out against Detroit. Booty Livers on top of her, going to pick up a penalty right there with a look of, I don't know if I agree with that. She will head off to the notorious RED penalty box, and 5 points go up for Susie Powell.
Susie Powell didn't need any offense right there, going with just her footwork to get through, getting a little bit of offense this time.
But great movement, a couple roll-offs right there for Susie Powell. She had a rough start, but she's really picking it up here in the second half, and another 5 points goes up. Power jam is over. Allison Shoverland speeds through an off-guard pack. Is now eligible to score for Detroit.
Yvette O'Work faking with the offense there, trying to get Susie Powell just a couple more points before she calls off that jam.
And she calls it off as she cuts the track, so it's going to be a power jam in this next one for Detroit. Brilliant move and some high fives on the bench for Al McPherson.
Well, Charm City was able to cut the lead to only 40, breaking across the 100-point barriers. We've got Detroit with 144, Charm 104. We've got 16 minutes left to play in the first half, but it's now Detroit in the power jam, and they will be sending Roxanna Hardplace to jam for them.
Yeah, formidable three-pack out in front of her. We've got Cookie Rumble, Razor McChaser, and Bruisey Sue. Charm City also fielding three defenders as well. They're down their jammer, but they're going to look to Holly Go Hardly, battery operated, and Oh Chit. Lady Kaboom sitting in the box. Roxanna Hardplay is going to have to push up on her toe stops. She's getting that chest push, draws the out of play, and one lead jammer Detroit.
Passive offense, 8 seconds for her to get through on her initial pass.
3-2 pack, Detroit going passive right there. Roxanna sped into the infield right there. Another jab defensively. She gets pushed to the outfield, and a cut is forced right there on Roxanna Hardplace. So the power jam will end for Detroit, and one will begin anew for the ladies from Baltimore.
Stagnant offense again, over 10 seconds trying to push through that wall, and ultimately ended up in a track cut for Detroit. Charm City going to try and take advantage, AK.
That's right. Detroit back up to full strength on defense. Booty Livers there, the waiting greeting party for Susie Powell. Gets up to a wall of Detroit defenders. Having some difficulty there getting past. Big takedown, Cookie Rumble throwing the booty at her. Takes her down and out on the outfield in turn two. Springs right back up, having to reset.
Nice job by the Charm City blockers, not allowing her to recycle any further back, trying to get their jammer back on the track as quickly as possible, AK.
That's right, Jess Carroll rolled across that Detroit wall to try and break them apart. They quickly reformed, though. Oh, and a big pileup right there, and we're going to have a high block major being called on Booty Livers, and that, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm pretty sure I'm not, will be her seventh trip to the box and a first foul out of this game. That one for Detroit. 5-point grand slam right there for Roxanna Hardplace as this jam continues.
Susie Powell was definitely looking for the high block on that, and she did get that call.
Ooh, and looking for the high road around the outside. 4 quick points for Roxanna Hardplace. Nobody out there in the Netherlands towards the outfield to defend her.
Susie Powell struggling against that two wall up front of Detroit blockers. Passive offense not doing them any favors right now.
That's right, nice takedown from Bruzy Sue. Major track cut on her right at the end of that jam. 3 points go up for Susie Powell, but a grand slam right at the end for Detroit. It's going to make it 158 to 108. We've got 13:15 remaining.
Well, and AK, you were right. As that jam was coming to its conclusion, our announcer liaison coming over and informing us that, in fact, Boo D. Livers has picked up her 7th penalty this game.
That's right. 3 in the second half. She had a forearm, a direction of gameplay, and the high block, which sent her out. Sub in the box for her. Back to the action on the track, though. It's going to be lead jammer Jess Carroll and Charm City as Feta Sleaze, oh, taken down hard right there.
Feta Sleaze being held up by that 3 wall in the backfield. Once they got separated, though, Feta Sleaze clear on her initial.
Direction of gameplay penalty to Fatal Femme leaves one defender out there for Detroit, and that is Spanish Assassin gets bumped to the outfield. We do have a call off right here. So it'll be a 0-0, and Detroit in dire straits right now, missing 3 of their 4 defenders coming into this next one, Mike.
Jess Carroll able to pick up 4 points there. Again, remember in the first half, we've got a team timeout real quickly, a team timeout being called by Detroit, I believe. Yep, that's what the scoreboard is telling me, at least. We talked about the fact that Jess Carroll had credit with only 2 jams as a jammer in the first half, did not pick up a single lead jammer status in that first half. Coming back the second half after playing pivot a majority of the first half, being met with some jammer success now.
Indeed, Mike. And things have changed a little bit here. It's kind of what we saw for most of the first half. Detroit in the lead, but Charm City keeping it interesting. Detroit pulled away right at the end of the first half, and the lead is the difference right now. 46 points in favor of the Detroit Derby Girls, 158 to 112. We've got 12:19 remaining, and we are in what appears to be a timeout, but the refs are discussing it. I did see Coach Speedy Pants go into the infield and have the some conversation with the refs. They are conferring, but it appears this is just a standard timeout.
Well, fans, while I've got a moment, I would like to thank Fifth Blocker Skates. Don't be scunnered. We've got hundreds of stuff at Fifth Blocker Skates. Find out more at fifthblockerskates.co.uk.
Back here in America, in Salem, Oregon, getting ready for this next jam coming out of Detroit's second timeout. 158 to 112 in favor of Detroit, and it's Allison Shoverland up against the Nuckin Futz.
Allison Shoverland, nice job of jammer defense in the backfield, though. However, Nuckin Futz threw lead jammer status, Charm City.
She is just so twitchy out there. Nuckin Futz, just great movement back and forth. Her jukes go at the speed of light right there, taken down hard by Cookie Rumble. Meanwhile, Feta Sleaze going down very hard, and she is struggling to get up. We have a timeout. The jam was over.
Well, not only
mistaken.
Not only do we have Feta Sleaze go down, but we also had the jammer for Charm City, as you saw on your screen there, go down in turn two, and we get another look at that right now. She's going to get bumped to the outside of turn two there, and you look at the way that she fell right there. You see that. It came up wincing, called off the jam. Two skaters down in the same jam. Now the jammer for Charm City returns to her bench, AK.
Yeah, she did pick up three, did knuck and futz right there. It's going to make it 158 to 115. Still waiting to see what's up with Feta Sleaze for Detroit. See there, Charm City taking a knee, the tradition of Derby for the Fallen Skater. Both teams typically take a knee, as well as the officials. A tradition I'm proud to say that we did start in Detroit many, many moons ago. Well, and several suns. We don't see the sun much in Detroit, but we can tell the days thanks to, you know, time that was invented by the people a long time ago.
Well, Feta Sleaze back up and returns to her bench area on her own. That is always good to see. You pointed out Charm City taking a knee there. They took that knee right in front of the Antic Skate Boot jam line because they wanted to be there ready to set up for this next jam. Smart move by Charm City.
The end of the timeout whistle, not precursed with a "this does not start the jam," and everybody springs into action only to be told to settle down.
Wait for it, wait for it, Boogly. Roxanna Hardplace wearing the star for Detroit. Jess Carroll once again taking the jam cap for Charm City. She has had success here in this second half. Could it be attributed to Charm City taking the front of the jam line? Again, we shall see.
She does get some room there around her defenders to the inside of the field. She's got one to beat. Laser beam speeds past lead jammer Charm City. They're going on a bit of a tear here in the second half. Just Carroll with the finger of power pointed at her, but Roxanna Hardplace out of the pack as well.
Well, the three blockers went down in turn one. That is what freed Detroit's jammer on her initial pass. However, Charm able to roll four on that one.
And a lucky break right there. Just Carroll furiously trying to call off the jam. It seemed like the whistle was a little slow, but it gave her that extra time to spin around that last defender. She picked up all 4 points, and the jam was called off. No points for Detroit. Our score, 158 to 119. Charm City inching ever closer, 39 points of difference, and they've got 11 minutes to make that difference up.
Feta Sleaze and Susie Powell, your jammers of record this jam, AK.
That's right. Susie Powell being forced to the infield by Racer McChaser. Meanwhile, Feta Sleaze having a lot of trouble and getting tripped up there over a much smaller Charm City defender. Meanwhile, out in front, Susie Powell is lead jammer for Charm City.
That was Ochit, who has been whistled to the notorious RET penalty box for a low block. She's going to be followed by Holly Gohardley. Did not see the call on that, unfortunately.
Holly Gohardley picked up the out of play in that one.
I'm glad one of the two of us is paying attention.
I have a ringster.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Well, fans, pleased to be checking out CruiseSkateShop.com, offering quality tested derby gear and guidance since 2007. That is Cruise, C-R-U-Z, SkateShop.com.
There you see, as they're getting ready to start this next jam, Detroit plotting as to how they're going to respond to Charm City's two defenders taking the pivot line. Roxanna Hardplace making quick work of that two wall, picks up lead jammer for Detroit.
On opposite her, Jess Carroll, who's stuck battling a four wall in the back of the pack.
They get spread out, has one to beat, and Elle McPherson does push past her, but Roxanna Hardplace around on a scoring pass. Nice little whip off one of her teammates, spins her past that last line, bumps off one more defender, picks up four and says, no more, we'll wait 30 seconds, and then, hey, let's do it again, shall we?
Quick hit it and quit it for Detroit. Fans, check out AdamWheels.com. Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. We've got just over 9 minutes left to play here in this second half. Detroit leading Charm by a score of 162-121. And that is Cookie Rumble opposite Nuckin' Futz as your jammers this jam, AK.
Cookie Rumble pushing her way through up front, picks up lead jammer, and a great job by Detroit responding right there. Nuckin' Futz, Charm took that front line to give Nuckin' Futz room, but Detroit was right there to stop her.
Nice bridge work by the Detroit blockers right there. Nuckin' Futz goes round the outside to clear on her initial pass.
Defense from the outside to the inside opens up room for Cookie Rumble. One last beat, speeds past, calls it off, and that's going to be a 4-0 jam in favor of the wily veteran Cookie Rumble for the Detroit Derby Girls.
Well, and some nice positional blocking up front by Battery Operated for Charm City there near the end of that jam. Fans, we would like to thank Crazy Skate Shop Company and Green Monster, proud partners of the WFTDA.
5 seconds is the call. Everybody eagerly awaiting the start of this jam.
Jess Carroll finds herself wearing the jam cap once again for Charm City, and that was Feta Sleaze, her opposition for Detroit.
Feta Sleaze bouncing back nicely after getting knocked around a little bit a couple jams ago, picks up lead jammer right there for Detroit, but Jess Carroll out as well.
We've talked about the nimble ability of the Charm City jammers. However, it was Feta Sleaze there showing off her fancy footwork for Detroit and picking up lead jammer.
Detroit's going to lose two blockers, so 4-2. Feta Sleaze gets in there, tries to call it off. Again, a couple seconds pass, and it looked like Jess Carroll got in there to score points before it was over. 1 point goes up for Detroit.
Nice squeeze by the Charm City defense there in turn two to only give up 1 point. Oh, no, it has been changed now to 3 points.
3 points right there for Charm City.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, that's Feta was pushed to the outside. She was behind some defenders trying to call it off, out of the view of the jam ref, and that gave Charm enough time to get in there and pick up those 3 points.
Susie Powell and Roxanna Hard place your jammers of record to start this jam, and it's Charm City starting out on the jam line.
Great movement right there for Charm's jammer. 4-2 pack advantage was used properly by Charm right there. Ooh, tough defense forces Roxanna Hardplace to the outfield, comes back in, finishes her initial pep, picks up a major forearm.
Major forearm penalty there. Susie Powell got through the pack, picked up 5 points on that scoring pass.
And Charm City charging back right now. Pack moving backwards. Racer McChaser has to spring into action the opposite direction of the pack. No pack is called, and she lets her go.
Nice choreographed movement by the Charm City blockers there, trying to string out this pack, allowing Susie Powell to just roll and roll and roll. 5 more points, Charm City.
Racer McChaser called out for an out of play after she was coming back. I'm not sure if that was a failure to reform or what the case may be, but she is in the queue, and that is it for Racer McChaser when she goes to the box. 7 minutes for her. Picked most of them up in the first half. There she goes off to the box as Detroit gets two defenders back. Racer McChaser is done for this one.
Susie Powell through the pack. Another 5 points for Charm City.
Detroit trying to keep it tight right now. Susie Powell forced to the infield, gonna have to come back, reset behind Fatal Femme. Fatal Femme there to pick her up. Charm City staying out in front. Oh, and a big hit right there after the whistle on Roxanna Hardplace is gonna mean a minute in the box for Holly Go Hardly, and that is her 7th trip to the box. She is done as well. So in that jam, we see Racer McChaser and Holly Go Hardly, two big players for their team, done for the day.
And there we see Susie Powell coming around and taking
a low block.
Yep. And she was not happy about it. You could see that on her screen as she was getting up. She was not happy about that at all. So, that is 3 skaters now that have fouled out in this bout. 2 for Detroit, that is Racer McChaser, number 28, and number 247, Boo Delivers. And then you said Holly Go Hardly was the 7-4 Charm City. And fans, I don't know if you've noticed this, but at the bottom of your screen there, the score reads 167-153. Detroit leading Charm still, but by only 14 points. We are just inside 5 minutes left to play in the second half. And keep in mind, I am Payne, co-captain of Charm City, probably sitting out this bout with a minor injury. That puts them down 2 of their 14 skaters, and Detroit, minus Boo Delivers and Racer McChaser, now short 2 skaters of their own. So we essentially have 12-on-12 on the benches.
Indeed, Mike, and this has gotten very interesting. Charm City took great advantage of the power jam that sent Roxanna Hardplace to the box for that forearm, and they have closed the gap now to, as you said, 14 points, 459 remaining, 167-153 in favor of Detroit, down two very, very important players.
So we have a conference still going on. One inside the notorious RED penalty box, one inside the center of the track. And fans, we would like to thank Rydell Skates, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Check them out at RydellSkates.com.
So the situation as it stands, just under 5 minutes remaining, 14 points in favor of Detroit. 2-2 pack, Cookie Rumble versus Just Carroll. Cookie Rumble sneaks through on the inside. Just Carroll was held up long enough for Cookie to pick up lead. Right there, forcing the cut. Oh, but a forearm on Cookie Rumble means it's a power jam for Just Carroll.
On Just Carroll, dangerously close to picking up a track cut there, managed to keep one skate out of bounds at all times, which was necessary.
It would have been a track cut, except for the fact that Cookie Rumble went to the box for the forearm. Right there, 5-point grand slam for Charm City brings us to within 9.
Stagnant offense by Charm City, but only 2 blockers for Just Carroll to beat. Taking her some time, though.
Fatal Femme doing a good job staying out in front of Carroll. She's going to have to let her go, but time is of the essence here, and if they can slow her down on this power jam, tick off some of those seconds, that could be the difference, Mike.
Charm City closing this to a 4-point bout. Just Carroll trying to possibly force a lead change here on this scoring pass. 5 in the sky, Charm City. Charm by 1.
167-168. Charm taking the lead. Coming up again, Just Carroll running into the pack.
Battery operated, getting Just Carroll some offense there. And another 5 in the sky, Charm City.
6-point lead now for Charm. 3.5 left in the first. Cookie Rumble out of the box for Detroit. 1 to beat Loretta Scars, and she is done with her scoring pass. 4 points for Detroit right now.
Battery operated, heading to the notorious RED penalty box for Charm City.
4 points for Just Carroll right there. Cannot call it off. Cookie Rumble was lead before she went to the box. Way out in front, they go down. Out of play penalty is called right there. Cookie Rumble picking up another 4 to answer back. Loretta Scars off to the box right now. Just Carroll taking a hit from Fatal Femme, but Cookie Rumble speeding through on another scoring pass. So 4-4 in that last one.
We're going to wait and make sure that we've got the upstated scoreboard here. Jess Carroll, nice job on that last scoring pass. Goes to one leg, keeping herself in bounds to complete the scoring pass.
Holy shnikes. We have 179-181. Charm City with a 2-point lead right now. Detroit has led the majority, if not all of the game coming in to this last big run for Charm. Penalties continue to be an issue for both teams. 2-2 pack. Who do we have jamming, Mike?
Looks like we've got Susie Powell jamming for Charm City, and that's number 3, Roxanna Hard plays for Detroit.
Susie Powell gets pew-pewed to the outside by Laser Beam. Enough time for Roxanna Hard plays to pick up lead jammer. Bruzy Sue off to the box, another penalty for Detroit. They've only got 1 out there in Laser Beam. Roxanna Hard plays gets in, forced to the inside right there. She's going to come back and reset. Laser Beam again taking down Susie Powell. Another defender gone.
Low block
right there is going to send a number 110 for Charm off to the box.
That's Yvette O'Work. She's back in the notorious RED penalty box. Susie Powell, small jump of the apex, followed by Roxanna Hard plays. Point for point, these jammers matching each other, AK. What a finish we've got here in Salem.
That's right. Roxanna Hardplay spins around right there and calls it off. And she's straddling the line, picks up 3. 2 more points going up for Charm. And that's going to make it a 1-point game in favor of Detroit. No, wait, sorry. 1-point game, score update. 2 points. I'm going to wait and let them do this. I'm sorry. Let me wait. Okay, score has been updated. 192 Charm, 194 Detroit. Charm leading by 2.
On AK, I'm really surprised to see Just Carroll on the jam line, but her blocker's up on the pivot line to start this jam. I do know we are in a micro pack to start, though.
That's right. Allison Chutterland threw on the inside lead jammer for Detroit, but right behind her is Just Carroll. Both teams back up to 3 blockers in the pack.
Off your screen, Just Carroll about 2.5 strides behind Racer McChaser. Allison Chutterland.
Allison Chutterland getting in quick right now. She's calls it off right there. Picks up 3, retakes the lead. for Detroit. One-point game right now.
Team timeout, Charm City, sorry. Team timeout, Charm City. We are under 30 seconds to play. Holy cow, AK.
Whew, yeah, 25 seconds remaining. 193-192 in favor of Detroit. And Mike, what a crazy second half we have had here. Power jam for Charm City. They brought it back, and it's been back and forth. They pulled ahead. Detroit pulls ahead now. And we've got 33. They've fixed the scoreboard. 33 seconds remaining. Now, and they did not need the timeout to get the extra jam in, but I think it's a good idea to take a timeout, collect yourself, and figure out what you're going to do
well
in this next one.
And worst case scenario, it could be a two-for-one situation right here. I like what I saw. Charm City taking their timeout with the blockers on the track right in front of the Antic Skate Boot jam line. Now, however, they give up that position to Detroit with Susie Powell wearing the star. For Charm City, Roxanna Hardplace, jammer of record for Detroit.
Fatal Femme, Feta Sleaze, and Spanish Assassin out for Detroit blocking. They're opposed by Free Radical, Battery Operated, and Oh Chit.
Derby fans and addicts, it all comes down to this.
What better of a... Wow. Couldn't ask for more. Susie Powell looking for room. Gets out first, though, is lead jammer for Detroit. That is Roxanna Hardplace. All she has to do is outscore and stay out of the box. Time ticking down. 17, 16, 15. Pack speeding up. Charm City losing blockers right now.
Free Radical to the penalty box for Charm City. Jam called.
Roxanna Hardplace calls it off, but time left. And a quick timeout. Great move right there by Mr. Pistol for Charm City. Another jam. Detroit picks up the points. They extend their lead 196-192. But with 4 seconds remaining, they're going to have to make another stand, Mike.
Well, and like I said, AK, I was really surprised by Charm City. During that last team timeout, the blockers on the track had stayed right in front of the jam line, like that's where they were going to set up their positioning. Then all of a sudden, the Detroit blockers hit the track, and Charm City, for whatever reason, decides to give up that positioning to them. Now, with Jess Carroll back out on the track in the jammer position, we see the Charm City blockers right on that jam line. Wow.
Indeed. Wow is really all you can say right now. I'm just talking to fill time. Oh my goodness, everybody standing here in Salem for this final jam, and it will be the final jam. And you know what, looking back, that timeout was advantageous for Charm City.
Like we said, a possibility of a two for one there, and that is exactly what Charm City got out of that situation.
That's right, Roxanna Hardplace calling it with time left, and now we've got Cookie Rumble up against Just Carroll. Both vets, a lot of experience out there on the track for both teams. Just Carroll looking for room, but is swarmed by Detroit. Cookie Rumble dealing with the three wall in back. Just Carroll pushing up front. She's got two to beat. Pack gets spread out right there. She's got to let her go. Lead jammer goes to Charm City, and Just Carroll. Cookie Rumble still held up in the back of the pack. She's going to fight through and is done with her initial pass.
Cookie Rumble gets the three wall of Charm City blockers to crumble. Now it's on the shoulders or the wheels of Jess Carroll as she's trying to make her way through that pack.
And what a great defensive stand right there from Bruzy Sue holding back Jess Carroll. Cookie Rumble coming in on her scoring pass as well. Three defenders. Cookie Rumble pushes through. That's going to be 4 points for Detroit. Jess Carroll finishing her scoring pass. 4 points for her as well.
Charm City's going to have to keep this jam going. Points are even right now, but Detroit still with a 4-point lead on the scoreboard, AK.
That's right. Cookie Rumble getting into the pack right now, getting held up. Bruzy Sue forcing Jess Carroll into the infield. Goes down, straddles the line, and she's going to go out. Bleeding blockers right now. Charm City, Jess Carroll slow to get up, but Bruzy Sue now, late penalty coming in on her. Rejoins the pack. Box was full. Jess Carroll still fighting through, but Cookie Rumble with 4 points.
Blocker advantage 3-2 in favor of Charm City on the track right now. Jess Carroll fighting up against the Detroit two wall in the front of the pack.
Gets knocked to the infield right there by Fetta Sleaze, and a fantastic job here by the two-wall Fetta Sleaze. And Bruzy Sue forces the cut on Just Carroll, and Cookie Rumble has a power jam to end this one out. All she has to do is stay out of the box and let time burn down. She's getting the call from the bench. Cookie, it's open skate time.
Bruzy Sue with the most devastating truck and trailer I've seen since Optimus Prime.
And Cookie Rumble right there with a grand slam on this power jam. 9-8-7. We're going to get the countdown here in Salem. Detroit up 209-196. 13 points the difference, and nothing Charm can do with their jammer in the box. It's all over. And after a nail-biting barn burner, three more points go up for Charm City. But Detroit, by 10 points, are the victors. Sighs of relief, exuberant exaggeration coming from my mouth because, oh my goodness, Mike Checks, what a finish to that game.
What an amazing finish to the bout, and the fans here in Salem all on their feet. Everybody, eyes glued to the track. Absolutely amazing.
199-209. Charm City almost had it, but they fall in the end with a beautiful forced track cut by Bruzy Sue, who out there just did a stellar job. Oh my goodness gracious, great balls of fire. 10-point win for Detroit, and they will move on and play the winner of Bad Victorian at 6 o'clock. So you know, they got to go back to their locker room, talk about some of those penalties, and then collect themselves to come back and watch that game. Now, I have to mention, Mike, we didn't get a chance to get into this before the bout started. Charm City, the last 3 years, has gone to champs and been defeated in the quarterfinals and then the first round. Detroit has not made the trip to champs in the last 3 years. This gets them one step closer to Milwaukee.
That's right, the road to Milwaukee starting right here for Detroit. And you know, AK, there were some great performances up and down both of these rosters, both for Detroit and Charm City. But I think you said it best, Bruzy Sue, probably Detroit's MVP for drawing that track cut in the final jam. Amazing piece of blocking by Bruzy Sue. And fans, I hope that you enjoyed that one. What an amazing finish.
Yeah, you couldn't ask for anything more. Today has been so interesting, Mike. At first, we had Toronto with the massive upset over number 7, Sacred City. 215-90, the ladies from Toronto come in and upset number 7. Then Victorian with a powerful victory over the Chicago Outfit, 8-9. So this is our first victor this weekend from the United States of America.
That's right.
And it's your Detroit Derby girls from the Motor City.
That's right. Detroit. Detroit still alive in this tournament, and hopes of Milwaukee on their minds. What an amazing performance. I'm floored. That was an amazing finish for these.
Indeed.
For these teams.
And you know, look at the steal of Cookie Rumble out there jamming. Just Carroll got lead, but Cookie forced through, kept up with her. She was keeping pace, overtook her, and then the forced track cut. I mean, Detroit had the lead at that point, but she just kept calm, kept collected, and kept fighting through. And this is a redemption game because Detroit at regionals the last couple years, as I said, have fallen. They've been fourth and fifth in the regional playoffs the last 3 years. And it's, you know, we've seen those last second jams that have not gone their way, but this time it does. All right, so I'm AK 40 Ounce, Mike Checks.
We're going to kick it over to LeGrand Mort, who is down there conducting an interview, it sounds like. Good to work with you, sir. Thank you.
You too. Mort, take it away.
LeGrand Mort here, trackside with veteran skater I Am Payne for Charm City. I Am Payne, tough, tough game for you guys. But you guys just delivered the first nail biter of this playoff. That has to feel pretty good.
It does. I'm glad we stayed in it the whole time. We were behind for a little while, and some teams, you know, might think they're out of luck there. But we fought till the very, very last second, and that's something you can always be proud of.
Absolutely. Now, I know that this is not the position that you personally wanted to be in for this game. As a sideline player for injury, what sort of support can you give to your team to help them out in tough competitions such as this?
Well, we chose to roster me anyway so that I could kind of serve as a third bench coach, and I was able to give immediate feedback directly to the jammers and the blockers as they were coming off of the track that sometimes the bench coaches can't always do because they have to then focus again back on what's going on the track. So I was able to just immediately give some feedback, and I feel like I was able to help in that way.
Speaking of immediate feedback, was there a moment in the game where you were like, we can get this back, we can absolutely get this back, and then was there a moment when you thought, nope, this is not coming back for us?
I think the whole time I always thought we could get this back, because really at this point in the game, there anything can happen. You can never know if like a jammer penalty is going to go in your favor, you know, so you can always get it back. I guess the only point where I thought I couldn't get it back was when our jammer went to the box in the final seconds of the game.
Yeah, that's always tough when it happens right there at the end.
Yep.
So what we've got coming up next is we've got Toronto playing Atlanta. Toronto coming out of nowhere. You know, not a lot of experience with Toronto up until this point, able to take Sacred City out. What sort of impact do you think that the international teams are having on the WFTDA playoffs and championships at this point?
I think international teams are bringing a lot because you don't see them as often as you see the teams in the continental U.S. because you see them a lot, you play them a lot. So the international teams are really bringing like some kind of mystery to it. Like you don't really know what to expect. And I think that's always great for the sport.
Absolutely. Well, good luck on your game with Sacred City later on. And we're going to send it right back to some words for our sponsors. I am Payne, La Grande Mort for WFTDA TV.
Bring it in. Keep coming. Oh, time for an upgrade. Radar Presto.
Say, these are nice.
Stunning.
On you go.
Is Brenda Gold, and I've been at Rydell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.